And right now, Terry and I want to just take a few moments, and I don't know if we would consider ours. I will not consider myself a marriage expert. I don't know about you.
Me neither.
But in the years I've been married, some things I have learned have helped me, and maybe they can help some other people. So we're each going
to
share.
Well, it's kind of interesting to hear it from a male perspective and then a female perspective, I think.
Yeah.
So share some of the things.
Well, number one, the day I was getting married, my grandfather, over 90 years old, told me two things. One, get a toupee, which I passed on. Secondly, he said, Andy, come here. And he pulled me in. He'd been married over 50 years.
Oh.
He said, learn her ways.
Wow.
And it seemed pretty simplistic, but you understand a marriage.
It all sounds simple till you're in the
What does she like? What does she not like? Mm-hmm. What annoys her? What pleases her? What makes her feel special? What makes her feel hurt?
Yeah.
It's simple. Learn her ways. And once we learn them, put it into practice. Mm-hmm. Don't ignore it.
You know, it's simple, but it is what you said earlier that I think will apply to every one of these things we discuss, which is be intentional. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, absolutely. Very important. Mm-hmm. And number two is something my wife shared with me once, and boy, it stayed with me. She said, I want you to love me when I'm not lovable.
Oof.
And so number two would be love each other when you're not lovable.
Boy.
Sometimes it's hard to love the spouse when they've angered you or hurt you.
Yeah.
Or they're icy, but in those moments, she said it clearly, Andrew, love me when I'm not lovable. And it was great advice, and maybe that can help some other people. Number three, don't yell, ever. When my wife and I fight, it is so quiet. I will say something, we're not yellers.
Cut through the air with a knife.
I will say something, and like, you know, 90 seconds later, she responds. And then a couple minutes later, I'll come. It's kind of a strange way to communicate, but we've made it a point not to yell. We don't want our children to hear us yelling.
Yeah. Well, usually when you begin to escalate and get to the yelling point, you start saying things you don't really want to say to each other. And you know, words are powerful things. So smart move.
Tip number four, I learned initially from Andy Stanley, great pastor in Georgia, son of Charles Stanley. Marriage is not 50-50. Another way of saying that is it's 100% to zero.
Yeah.
A lot of us think it's 50-50. You treat me a certain way. I treat you a certain way. We each have equal influence in the marriage.
Yeah.
This is tough, but if we can approach marriage as in, I'm going to serve my spouse 100%, it's hard, it may be impossible, but imagine if we each have that perspective.
Mm-hmm. Well, there's always that fear that if I really am that humble and my focus is serving my husband, that I'm going to get walked on or my needs aren't going to be met. But true servanthood really comes without concern for self.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's really all about the other person.
It's a great perspective to have. And number five is stand for each other.
Yeah.
That's not only in prayer, but that's a great way to do it, which I experienced recently as I shared. But when other people are critical of your spouse, let them and your spouse know that you are there to protect them. You may not always agree with your husband or wife's perspective on something, but boy, is it important to stand for your spouse.
Yeah, absolutely. Some of the things we say here may not be exactly the same, but they kind of, you know, journey together. Well, my first one is to keep kindness and courtesy. I remember going to a friend's wedding, and that was what the pastor spoke on in the wedding, was to keep courtesy with each other. I thought, what does that mean, keep courtesy with each other? But speaking with respect and kindness to each other. And even when you're, maybe not even when, especially when you're angry or frustrated, to not say, you know, the words are so powerful. And when you start unleashing them, boy, it's hard to pull that back in, you know, and that tone is what wounds the other person and hurts them. Second was, love is not easily offended. You know, that's in the lineup in 1 Corinthians 13. It's my favorite part of 1 Corinthians 13 because I think we are all too easily offended in our marriages, in our relationships with other people. And if you trail that back to the source, it's really all about me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you've hurt my feelings, you've wounded me, you've said something unkind. So, you know, I think that's a very important segment. And then speak words of respect to each other. You know, studies show, I speak about this from a woman's perspective for men, that women love, you know, being told that they're loved, feeling safe and secure. But for a man, the thing that's significant from his wife is to feel that she respects him. And, you know, sometimes when you're frustrated with someone or they're not measuring up to your expectation, showing respect is a difficult thing. But, you know, if it was easy, everybody'd do it. If it was easy, the divorce rate wouldn't be what it is. These are things that you have to intentionally do to embrace a successful relationship. Number four, forgive, and add affirm at the end of that. Yeah, well, I threw a fourth one in just for good measure. It's true. You know, if you are constantly, we say we forgive each other, but then if you're like me, I get in the car and I'm making laundry lists. Well, he didn't do this and he didn't do that. And then he said this. And pretty soon the laundry list is a report card, you know, on the person. And then the Lord quietly speaks to my heart. Do I do that to you with your shortcomings? And thankfully, the answer to that is no. And he's calling us to be more than that. And then laugh a lot. You know, I think my husband and I are married 34 years. And one of the things through the hard times is just being friends. You know, we go through some things with the kids that you just have to laugh. Because if you don't laugh, you're going to smack somebody. But I'm saying laugh together. Have fun. You only get to do life once. And I think friendship is the core of what keeps a marriage together. Truly liking and enjoying the other person in your relationship.
Sometimes we say to the Lord, you know, I want to thank you for what you've done for me. I want to show you my gratitude. A great way to show love for God is to show love to your spouse.
Boy, it's true. It's true. Absolutely.
Well, thank you for your tips. I'm going to put them into practice.
And yours.
Forgive, 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 and affirm.
And then laugh.